students, this is Ms. Sophia, and today's topic of presentation is the people of Pakistan in South Asia, Chapter 14, Grade 6 of your Geography section. The population of South Asia. Objectives to know the origin, statistics, rural-urban breakup of population mainly in Pakistan as well as South Asia. Resources, textbook, encyclopedia and internet I have used. Statistics. Statistics is a means of giving information in numbers, charts or graphs. As it is easier to show and understand the data more clearly. Government frequently publish information about the country in the form of statistics, as you have already seen in some of the graphs about production areas, etc. In this section, you will learn about the sum of the government statistics about the people of Pakistan. The map on page number 62 shows a list of many different races that invaded the subcontinent over the last 35 years. Most of them came from East and Central Asia through the Northwest where Pakistan now stands. Most of these invaders left behind some traces of their presence. Some settled down in the country permanently, Aryan and Mughals, for example. Sometimes the invading soldiers married local women and remained behind. As a result, the people of Pakistan are very varied. However, main groups are these. Aryan, Rajputs, Jats and all. Punjabis consider themselves to be separate races. There are small groups such as Bohris in Sindh and the Saraikis in Punjab and the Kafirs of the far north who also consider themselves distinct races. During partition, millions of Muslims from other parts of the subcontinent came to Pakistan, adding to this mixed population. Because of the population of Pakistan came from so many different backgrounds, there are many languages spoken here. Population births and death in rural areas. Why do you think are the numbers of births and especially deaths of babies, infant mortality so much higher in the rural areas than in the urban ones? Note the difference between the birth rate and the death rate. What does this mean for the population of a country as a whole? What problems can this cause? The death rate are higher in the rural areas in South Asia generally because of social condition, inadequate access of medical care, ignorance of low literacy, traditional method of child rearing and a harder life in a physical sense. Overpopulation. In most of developing countries, as we can see that there is a tradition to have many childs because of the high death rate and the lack of medical care. Today, far more of the children survive infancy and more live on into old age. China, where the difficulty was even greater, the government has limited each family to just one child. Now, China considering two child per family because of recent natural calamities and mainly cause it will have a larger aging population in future. India is now expected to overtake China's population by the middle of the 21st century. Literacy. Literacy has increased in Pakistan due to the emphasis on education. In 1991, it was about 36% and in 2007, it was nearly 50%. Though this varies from region to region, the average literacy rate for women is about 35%, with the continued focus on improving education and making it as widespread as possible, the literacy rate is expected to rise. Now here question arises, why is literacy so important to a developing country? What problem would you encounter in everyday life if you could not read? Can you guess where the highest illiteracy rates are in Pakistan? Next heading is SARC. In the last few chapters, we have read about the Pakistan and the other South Asian countries. We have seen the similarities and differences in the in these regions. We have also seen how we share many common problems, whether the country is big or small in the area or population. There are other common features as well. So these seven countries, Bangladesh, Bhutan, India, Maldives, Nepal, Pakistan and Sri Lanka, set up an organization in 1985 by the name of SARC. I hope you all understand the topic really well. Now, answer these questions in your copy or in document form and send it to us. Thank you.